Good evening, children. So children, as you are aware that we are doing chapter number 3, that is our agriculture. In yesterday's class, we have studied about the food crops and non-food crops, areas of cultivation. So today I am going to start with non-food crops. So before starting, I would just like to tell you about whatever I have taught in yesterday's class. That is, we were talking about the food crops and the non-food crops. So today, children, the turn is of non-food crops. Okay, children, my voice is audible to all? Yes, children, my voice is audible to all or not? That's my question. Okay, so I'm now starting from non-food crops. Yesterday, we talked about non-food crops like rubber. We talked about areas of cultivation. So firstly, I am going to start from non-food crops. As by the name only, you can understand. As by the name only, you can understand that non-food crops mean those products which are not used for our eating purpose. Those products which are not in our eating, which are not meant for our eating purpose. So firstly, let's begin with rubber. It is an important, this rubber is an important industrial raw material. India is the fifth largest. India is the fifth largest producer of rubber in the world. Remember, India is the fifth largest producer of rubber in the world. Around about 97%, around about 97% of the country's demand of natural rubber is met from the domestic production. Means whatever demands arises in India, itself, 97% of the demand is completed from our domestic production. Here the meaning of this domestic production is that is being that all those demands are fulfilled by our own nation. Next is around 44.5% of natural rubber, 44.5% of natural rubber is used in manufacturing tires and tubes. 13.3% cycle tires and tubes. 11.2% footwear. Camelback 6%, belts and hoses 6.1%, and latex foam and dipped goods 5% one each. Means all these things are being used by, all the demands or the national demands are fulfilled by this rubber by India itself. Apart from all these things which I am saying, there are many other uses of natural rubber also. These are the daily things which we purchase and we use that I'm talking. Apart from this, there are other uses also, so many other things also which are made of rubber. Now, I've talked about crop. Now, let's talk about the areas of cultivation. What are the areas of cultivation of rubber? And this also, the South, the Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and Garo Hills of Meghalaya. are the major rubber producing areas. These are the major rubber producing areas. Next, conditions. Now the other question is, what are the conditions required for the cultivation of rubber? Now, first point, it is an equatorial crop. Second point, it grows well in tropical and subtropical areas. It grows well in the tropical and subtropical areas also. This crop requires a moist and humid climate. With rainfall of more than 200 centimeter. Just think about the rainfall, more than 200 centimeter. And the temperature should be above 25 degree. Now, as you can see on your monitor that I have just shown you the map. This is the map where at the bottom of the Deccan Belt of India, means at the bottom, you can see the main producers where the maximum production of rubber takes place. The areas are Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and even Meghalaya. So the bottom belt of Indian map covers the area of rubber production. Now, the next point is, now let's move to fiber crop. And children, today pay attention to my the topics which I am teaching, because during the end of the class, during the last 15-20 minutes, you will be having today so many questions. I made the entire set of nearly 10 questions which I'll be asking you in the form of MCQs. Now, I'm moving to fiber crop. Now, in the fiber crop, I'm going to talk about cotton. In the fiber crop, my topic is cotton. India is the third largest producer of cotton. India is the third largest producer of cotton in the world. And it is believed that the crop originated here. And it is also considered that this crop has originated from here only. This means the beginning of this cotton started from India itself. Cotton is used as a raw material in textile industry. Especially in India, if you know that the southern belt, again in this also the southern belt, maximum cotton is produced. Now, so remember one point, India is the third largest producer of cotton in the world. Now, let's talk about the areas of cultivation. The point is, areas of cultivation. Maharashtra, as you can see in the map, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh are the major cotton producing areas. These are the major cotton producing areas. In the map, you can see that blue color means the bluish color, the light bluish color is used for cotton. Light blue color is representing cotton. The areas are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. These are the major cotton producing states. Now, what are the conditions? Now the other question is, what are the conditions which are required for cultivation? The fiber crop grows well in the drier parts of the black cotton soil. The fiber crop grows well in the drier parts of the black cotton soil of the Deccan Plateau. It grows well in tropical and subtropical areas. It requires 6 to 8 months to mature. It takes nearly 6 to 8 months for its maturity and high temperature. The temperature should be very high and light rainfall. High temperature and light rainfall. It grows best with irrigated water. It grows best with irrigated water. Almost 210 frost-free days and bright sunshine are required for its growth. Again, remember this point. It grows best with irrigated water. Almost 210 frost-free days and bright sunshine are required for its growth, and as it is a kharif crop. If you see the southern belt of India, there the temperature is high, means the areas where it is being produced or where it is cultivated, there the temperature is quite high. And it takes a long duration of time, and the time needed for this crop cultivation is 6 to 8 months. Just focus on the map. By that you can come to know about the areas which are the main producers. Your Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Now, let's move to the other fiber crop. The other fiber crop is our jute. The other important fiber crop is jute. So let's talk about this. This crop, jute, is also known as the golden fiber. Jute is also known as the golden fiber. It is used to make mats. It is used to make mats, ropes, carpets, yarns, gunny bags, and many other ornamental things. Especially in the markets, you would have seen several people. Nowadays, most of the people are using the jute bags. When it was said that we don't have to use the polythene or the plastic bags, maximum jute bags or cotton bags came in production. But jute is a very costly product. Today, due to its high cost, people prefer to use synthetic fiber. Nowadays, as the jute is very costly, so people are preferring to use synthetic fibers and packing materials, especially nylon. And now the other question is, from where this fiber is obtained? From where this fiber is obtained? The fiber is obtained from the retting of the plant. Means from the plant itself, from the retting of the plant, we get the fiber. What are the main areas of cultivation? So if you see on the right hand side of the map, the areas which it covers is West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha, and Meghalaya. These are the major jute producing states. Again, I am repeating, on the right hand side of the map, see the bit brick color, that is representing your jute. West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha and Meghalaya are the major jute producing states. After that, what are the conditions? Now the next point is, what are the conditions required for cultivation of jute? So it requires well-drained fertile soil in the flood plains. Means especially takes place where water is enough. Well-drained fertile soil in the flood plains. Especially you can get it in West Bengal because there the water level or there is an ocean. Water-drained fertile soil in the flood plains. Second point, soil which is renewed every year. Third point, high temperature during the time of growth. It requires high temperature during the time of growth. So the major conditions required for its cultivation are well-drained, fertile soil in the floodplains. Second point, soil which is renewed every year. Third point, high temperature during the time of growth. Now, these are the main points. Now, one more thing is there. I have mentioned here, did you know, the four major natural fibers of India are cotton, remember the names? The four major natural fibers of India are cotton, jute, hemp, and natural silk. Cotton, jute, and hemp. Cotton, jute, and hemp are plant fibers. Silk is derived from the cocoons of the silkworms. Silk is derived from the cocoons of the silkworms. These silkworms are fed on mulberry leaves. Where do we get these silkworms? These silkworms are fed on mulberry leaves. Sericulture, remember this word, sericulture, is the practice of rearing silkworms for the production of silkworm. Now if the question comes, what is the practice of rearing silkworms for the production of silk fiber is known as, then what will be your answer? Your answer will be, that practice is known as sericulture. The practice is known by the name of sericulture. Our children, yesterday I have started this topic. Topic in the sense that we started from the point of food crops and the non-food crops. Yesterday we studied about the food crops, and today I have told the topics of the non-food crops. Before that, I would like to come to the main words which are used. Several new words were used which you should be aware of. Okay, and if you know the answer, you can send me. The first word is molasses. M-O-L-A-S-S. Now children, what is the meaning of this word molasses? Just type it fast. My word is molasses. M-O-L-A-S-S. I'm waiting for a response. Respond it fast. Molasses. Anyone? Saurabh, Ankush, Snigdha, Katyani, Kushagra. Anyone? What is the meaning of the word molasses? No one knows the answer. Okay, now let me tell the meaning of the word molasses. Firstly, the spelling is M-O-L-A-S-S. This word means thick, dark brown. Thick, dark brown juice. It is aided by the refining of sugarcane. Yes? Yes, the answer is correct, but I'm just changing the words. Okay. Now, all of you pay attention, Priya and all the children. Now, listen this definition. The word molasses, thick, dark brown juice obtained from raw sugar during the refining process. The thick, dark brown juice obtained from raw sugar during the refining process is known as molasses. Now the other question. Saurabh Shukla, now it is clear? Priya, now this word is clear? Molasses, Shitij, Ashi Patel, I need the response of all the people. It should not be that only two or three candidates are responding. Saurabh and Priya, this answer is clear to you? Okay, so I'm going to tell you the next term. My next word is annual crop. Now, what is the meaning of this word annual crop? It completes its life cycle. It completes its life cycle from germination to the production. From germination to the production of seeds within one growing season and then dies. Annual crop, it completes its life cycle from germination to the production of seeds and within one growing season, and after that or it dies. Next word, what is the meaning of beverage crops? The word beverage crops, these are the crops that give a potable drink other than water. These are the crops that give potable drink other than water. For example, tea, coffee, juice, etc. Examples are tea, coffee, jute, etc. Next point, plantation agriculture. The word plantation agriculture or plantation is a large farm. Plantation is a large farm which specializes on farming one type of crop to earn profit. It means certain farmers are there, certain rich farmers are there, those who do the farming of only one product, only one crop. And with that, they are able to earn huge profits. So I'm repeating it. Plantation is a large farm which specializes on farming one type of crop to earn profit. Next word is horticulture. Horticulture is the science and art of growing fruits, vegetables, flowers, or ornamental plants. The science and art of growing fruits, vegetables, flowers, or ornamental plants is known as horticulture. Next term, sericulture, which I have told you today only, rearing of silkworms, rearing of silkworms for the production of silk fiber is known as sericulture. I have told you all the important words which I have used in this particular part. Now, so I hope so that you all would be remembering the points which I have taught you. And just for a quick recapitulation, my points are, for a quick recapitulation, you can see sugarcane is tropical as well as subtropical crop. Sugarcane is tropical as well as subtropical crop. Second point, India is the second largest producer of sugarcane only after Brazil. India is the second largest producer of sugarcane only after Brazil. Third point, different oil seeds, different kind of oil seeds are grown, covering approximately 12% of the total cropped area of India. This topic we have studied yesterday. different oil seeds are grown covering approximately 12. You can see there the 12, the 12 number is written in short. That is 12% of the total cropped area of India. Next point is tea is an important beverage crop introduced in India initially by the British. Next point is tea is a labor intensive industry. Tea is a labor intensive industry and requires abundant, cheap and skilled labor. It requires abundant, cheap and skilled labors. Indian Arabic variety of coffee. Indian Arabica variety of coffee brought from Yemen is known as the world, is known in the world for its good quality. Remember the name Indian Arabica variety of coffee. It was brought from Yemen, is known in the world for its good quality. And in the year 2015, India was the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world after China. Remember, in the year 2015, India was the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world after China. Next point, in India, rubber is mainly grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Garo Hills of Meghalaya. Remember the names which I am taking means the southern part, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman, Nicobar. This is the areas which were on the bottom of the Indian political map or on the physical map. So it is also known, this area is also was also known by the name of Deccan Campaign. According to history, it is the Deccan Campaign Belt. Next point, jute, known as golden fiber. Jute is known as golden fiber. Grows well in well-drained, fertile soil. In the floodplains, where soils are renewed every year. Now, what is the meaning of this word? This word means that whichever are the sea areas, the water level is high and due to its waves or due to its gravitational power, due to its speed, it crosses, it covers nearly enough areas which are nearby of that area. So that's why the soil of that area, the floodplains of that area make the soils fertile, and as they renew the soil every year, so that's why the fertility rate is very high. That's why the fertility rate is very high. Now my next point. Now children, I hope so that these topics which I have taught you means started from yesterday until today, the topics are clear. Just mention yes or no in these topics which I have written. Just tell me, children. Kushal, Misty, Siddhant, Siddha, Priya, all the children. Sahil Shrivastava, Kushagra, all the children. Okay. So, children, now after this, I'm going to have the question round, means particular of this chapter, whatever topics we have studied. We are going to have the question round. And I would prefer that all the people should be giving the answer. It's not so that only particular children, means especially 2-3 children, are giving the answer. And during this time, the children should not skip in the sense of, it should not happen that I started asking the questions and you start leaving, means you just move to the other place. That should not be the criteria. We should try to give the answer maximum. The answer can be wrong, and there is no negative marking for that. So that's why there is no need to worry, and I'm starting with multiple choice questions. You will be on your screens, either on the mobile phone, on the laptop, you will be getting the question. Question is there, and the four options are there. You have to type it fast. So total, I am having the set of nearly 8 to 10 questions. Fine? So, I am starting. Now the game begins. As you can see on your screen, that the first question is, which of the following is the most important occupation of the people of India? The options are: option A, food gathering. Okay, so only 5 children have sent me the answer. Okay. Others, I'm waiting for others' response. Only 6 children have given the answer. What about others? Okay. Okay, correct answer. All the people, those who send the answer, the answer is correct. Katyani, where are you? Katyani Kushwaha, where are you? Send your answer fast. Okay. Children, now let's move to the second question. In the same speed, you should give the answers which you have given just now. Now the question is, Which of the following types of economic activity is agriculture? Option A, primary activity. Option B, secondary activity. Option C, tertiary activity. Option D, all these. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, correct. Other children also. Now all I need answer from all the children. Again, the same children are giving the answer. It's good that you people are giving the answers, but where are the others? Okay, it's good that all the children are giving the answer. I need the answer from other candidates also. Okay, now the next candidate, I'm going to put up my question, the next question, that is question number 3. Now, Now the question is, third question is visible. The question is, what is primitive subsistence farming known as in northeastern states like Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Nagaland? Options are horticulture, the second is penda, C jhuming, and the next is milpa. One, two, three, four. Four people have given the answer. Five people have given the answer. Six, seven. Okay. Yes. Others also, I need the answers from you children. Good. All the children, those who have sent the answers is correct. And the exact answer for this question is jhuming, that is J-H-U-M-M-I-N-G. Good. Now, the next question, within few seconds, it will be on your screen. And this is the fourth question that you are going to answer. Okay. The question is, which of the following types of farming is practiced in areas with high population pressure on land? Option A, primitive subsistence farming. Option B, intensive subsistence farming. Option C, commercial farming. Option D, plantation. Priya, read the question once more and then answer it. Satendra Avasthi, the same thing. Read the question again and then answer. Kushal Rai. Okay, your answers are reaching to me. Okay, my question was, yes, correct answer. Yes, I've got nearly 9-10 answers. The answers are correct except two people. Priya, send the answer again. Yes, now it's the correct answer. The answer is intensive subsistence farming. That was the fourth question. Now, the fifth question. Which of the following is not the principal crop grown? It will be displayed on your screen. You can see. I'm just speaking the question. Which of the following is not the principal crop grown in areas of intensive subsistence farming? Option A, yams and sweet potato. Option B, wheat. Option C, rice. And option D, cotton. स्निग्धा सिद्धांत प्रिया स्निग्धा एंड सिद्धांत सेंड योर आंसर Okay, so all the children have sent their answers. As I've told you, India is the second largest producer of rice in the world. And in the areas of intensive subsistence farming, the correct option for this is option C, that is rice. Because rice is a tropical crop and grows very well in the wet monsoon lands. So the correct answer is option C, rice. Now, I am moving to the next question. It will be displayed shortly. This is question number 6. I am speaking the question until in short span it would be displayed. The question is, in which of the following states rice is a commercial crop? Option A, West Bengal and Bihar. Option B, Jammu and Kashmir. But remember, now Jammu and Kashmir is not a state. Option C, Punjab and Haryana. Option D, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So I have got answers of Snigdha, Siddhant, Satendra Avasthi. Satendra Avasthi, look to the question again. Priya Yadav, your message is retracting. Okay. So yes, children, most of you, nearly all of you have written the correct answer. The answer is option C, that is Punjab and Haryana. Now, on the screen, you can see the question. My next question is coming. Which one of the following describes a system of agriculture where a single crop is grown on a large area? Option A, shifting agriculture. Option B, plantation agriculture. Option C, horticulture. Option D, intensive agriculture. Okay, children, so all of you have sent the answer nearly. The answer is right, and the correct answer for this question is plantation agriculture. Now, the next question. My next question is, and try to give the answers fast because only 2-3 minutes are left. My next question is, which of the following is a rabi crop? Rice, gram, millet, cotton. Other children, send your answer fast. Okay, just fast, children. Be fast in sending your answer. Four people have sent the answer, nearly 4-5, and out of that, two people have given the wrong answer. Three have given the wrong answer. Priya, look into your answer. It's wrong. Okay, yes. For this, the correct answer is gram. G-R-A-M. Correct answer is gram. My next question. As it would be visible, which of the following is a kharif crop? My question is, which of the following is a kharif crop? The options are barley, peas, bajra, and mustard. Which of the following is the kharif crop? Barley, peas, bajra, mustard. Type the answer fast so that we can cover two more questions. Yes, Priya, good. Siddhant, good one. Good. Misty, Shlok, good one. Answer is right. Good one. All the people are sending the correct answer. Now, the 10th question. For you, the last question for today is, which of the following crops, which of the following crops is produced during Zaid cropping season? Which of the following crops is produced during Zaid cropping season? Option A, sugarcane. Option B, muskmelon. Option C, groundnut. Option D, moong. Send the answers fast. Okay, children. So the answer for this question is sugarcane. The answer for this question is sugarcane. So for today, children, this much only, and I hope so that you would have enjoyed today's classes.